Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Topper's World. My name is Praveen Kumar and today we are going to learn about few high level sentences such as compound sentences, complex sentences, passive voice, conditional sentences, question sentences and how you can use them in IELTS writing task 2, task 1 and even in IELTS speaking. So let's learn one by one all these kind of sentences without wasting time. And the things are in front of you. The first example is of conditional sentences. In conditional sentence, if then first part is present indefinite and second part is future indefinite, हम इसको कैसे समझ सकते हैं कि अगर तुम मेहनत करोगे तो पास हो जाओगे. अगर तुम मेहनत करोगे तो पास हो जाओगे. If you work hard, you will pass. So if you work hard, this is present indefinite. You will shows future. So you will pass. This part is future indefinite and this part is present indefinite. Second sentence, this is of high level. If government provides free education, agar government free education degi, to poor students will also get educated. To wo bhi padh likh jayenge. The poor students will also get, will is showing future. तो सेकेंड पार्ट में आपने विल लगाना है. फर्स्ट इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इनडेफिनेट. सो दिस इज द टोटल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कंडीशनल सेंटेंस इन आईएल्स राइटिंग. इन एसे राइटिंग यू नीड टू राइट ओनली दिस स्ट्रक्चर इन एसे राइटिंग्स. नाउ वी विल लर्न अबाउट कंपाउंड सेंटेंसेस यूजिंग एंड, ईदर और, नीदर नॉर, नॉट ओनली बट ऑल्सो, सो एंड टू. Now here I'm having two simple sentences. He plays cricket, he plays football. So you can write both sentences by combining with conjunction and. He plays football and cricket. Okay, so you can also write this. He plays football as well as cricket. In place of and, you can also use as well as. You can also write same sentences. He plays both football and cricket. He plays both football and cricket. So in this way you need not to use and again. Now look at two sentences. You can take tea, you can take coffee. So choice is given. So yahan pe aapko choice milti hai. So how can we write this sentence? You can convert this sentence by using conjunction either or. So it will be like either you can take tea or coffee. Either you can take tea or coffee. So using these two words, we have combined both sentences into one sentence. Neither nor, na to ye na hi wo. So you cannot take tea, you cannot take coffee. Now both sentences are negative. Now you can combine both sentences by using neither nor. How can you do that? Neither you can take tea nor coffee. So now the sentence has become negative. So there are so many examples. Neither you can go to Shimla nor Srinagar in winter season. The next is not only but also. He is good in cricket. He can play football very well. No, both sentences can be written as one sentence. You will write like he is not only good in cricket. Not only good in cricket, but also play football very well. So in this way, new sentence can be written. He is not only good at cricket, but also play football very well. Next is, he is very old. He cannot walk properly. He cannot walk properly. Now, how we will use to here? He is too old to walk properly. So this is a much better sentence as compared to these two simple sentences. The same sentence can also be merged together or combined together using so. इसको so का इस्तेमाल करके भी हम इकट्ठा कर सकते हैं. He is so old that he cannot walk properly. This is also your complex sentence. ये complex भी बन गया आपका. Although या though both are used to show contrast. ये किस लिए आते हैं? Contrast. To show contrast. When two sentences opposite or one sentence is in positive sense and other is in negative sense, then we use although or though. Both have same meaning. In Punjabi we call them paave ke. In Hindi we call it yadyapi. तो although is formal and though is informal. In essay writings we use although, but in speaking we will use though. Meaning is same. पावें के in Punjabi. Now look at first two sentences. They are simple. He was sick. He took part in race. Both statements are contradictory. First is he was sick. Second is opposite. He took part in race. So now both sentences can be used using although. Although he was sick, then comma, he took part in race. So contrast statement has been shown here. जो even though जो होता है in this case, in even though we show surprise, we are surprised. So this is only the difference between though and even though. इसमें surprise का factor आता है. For example, the sentence is he didn't study. He did not study. He passed with good marks. So this is a surprise. So how you will write this sentence? Even though he did not study, फिर भी वो पास हो गया. Yet he passed with good marks. So in this way this sentence will be written. Otherwise there is no difference. You can also write this sentence with although or though. Now we are going to combine two sentences, simple sentences, with question word who. Ram is a boy. He stole my pen. Now you can write both sentences like this way. Ram is a boy who stole my pen. So many sentences can be made like Sachin is a player who played for India. Sachin is a player who played for India. Ravi is a boy who stood first in my class. Now we are going to use which. I bought a pen. The pen was red in color. Now new sentence is I bought a pen which was joke, which was red in color. यू कॉल मी आई विल हेल्प यू वेन एवर जब भी सो वेन एवर यू विल कॉल मी वेन एवर यू कॉल मी आई विल हेल्प यू वेन एवर यू कॉल मी आई विल हेल्प यू सो यू कैन राइट वेन एवर इन फ्रंट ऑफ फर्स्ट सेंटेंस एंड इरेज स्टॉप सो द सेंटेंस विल बिकम वेन एवर यू कॉल मी आई विल हेल्प यू वेर एवर मीन्स कहीं भी कितने भी सो सेंटेंस कैन बी लाइक दैट वेर एवर यू विल गो आई वेर एवर यू गो आई विल बी विद यू मैं तुम्हारे साथ होऊंगा तुम जहां भी जाओगे मैं तुम्हारे साथ होऊंगा नेक्स्ट इज वट एवर जो भी जेडी भी चीज आई विल ईट वट एवर यू सर्व मी तुम जो भी मुझे सर्व करोगे मैं वो खा लूंगा आई विल वेयर वट एवर शर्ट यू विल गिव मी आई विल वेयर तुम जो भी जानना चाहते हो वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू नो आई विल टेल यू मैं तुम्हें बतलाऊंगा आई विल टेल यू सो हाई लेवल सेंटेंसेस वट एवर गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स टू डू फॉर द पुअर पीपल इट कैन डू इजिली Whosoever, इसका मतलब होता है जो भी या जेड़ा भी मैच विच खेडना चाहता है उसनू 100 रुपया फीस देनी पवेगी जो भी मैच में खेलना चाहता है उसको 100 रुपये जमा करवाना पड़ेगा Whosoever wants to play in the match In the cricket match, he has to pay ₹100 as entry fees. Whosoever, जो भी तो इस तरीके से ये sentences बनेंगे Question sentence we will write in introduction of writing task 2. मान लो कि आपको टास्क आ गया अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट या एम्प्लॉयमेंट के ऊपर सो वो कैसे होगा इज इट पॉसिबल टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन नेक्स्ट few years so in this way you will write such kind of sentence in introduction and after that what your opinion is no definitely not means you are negative about that yeah you can say yes of course it is possible so in this way question sentence one question sentence can be written in introduction depending upon what kind of essay you get next video mein main aapko bataunga ki be aur being mein kya difference hai been kahan pe use hota hai has been had been shall have been or has plus have third form where we use all these things in writing and speaking so apne next video dekhne ke liye taiyar rahiye और आपको ये वीडियो कैसे लगा इसका रिस्पॉन्स आप डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में कमेंट बॉक्स में मुझे जरूर बताएं सो दैट आई विल मेक नेक्स्ट वीडियो इवन बेटर देन दिस वन